all, let me congratulate you on having such a eventful and good event here. It was very enlightening. Now let me put forward my question. Now we have seen some interesting debates, some very curious arguments in favor of a religion against another religion. What we're doing is a comparative study in religions. A very logical question. Our goal is not to continue compare religions or say one is better than the other. Our goal is a better society, a better life, a better world, a peaceful world with more compassion and harmony. What is the logical conclusion of this all? Are we saying that till everybody in the world is not Muslim, we are not going to have a continuum and equilibrium? Or till everybody is not going to be Christian, we are not, because until unless everybody is one, this argument is going to continue. What is our goal? What are we heading to?
Brother asked the question that we had good arguments, good debates. What is the ultimatum? Do you want to make everyone Muslim? Do you want to make everyone Christians? What is ultimate? Ultimate is to search for peace.
Through?
Through the Creator Almighty God.
The path?
The path?
Because there is only one path.
One path is submitting our will to God.
And that is only one path, which we know what it is.
Yes, submitting our will to God.
Yeah, so there has to be only one conclusion.
One conclusion, correct. Inna Dina Indallah Al-Islam.
So the logical end to this is the entire world becomes a Muslim.
Not logical end to it. The thing is there that if those who get the truth, those who Allah gives hidayah, they'll become Muslim. Our job is to deliver the message. The Quran mentions in Surah Ghashiyah, chapter number 88, verse number 21-22, Allah says to the messenger, فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُذَكِّرْ. Your job is to deliver the message. Changing hearts, you are not the manager of affairs. لَسْتَ عَلَيْهِ مُسَيْطِرْ. You are not the manager of affairs.
I agree.
It is Almighty God. So what are we doing? We are delivering the message.
I agree.
Changing hearts in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not in our hand.
I agree.
What we are doing, are we getting peace or not? The thing to be noted is, when people say this is the best religion, and if someone else says this is the best, there is comparative study. And logically we can find which is the best.
But we cannot continue to compare till the end of the world. There has to be an end.
Not till the end of the world, till the end of my life.
Oh.
Till the end of your life. We are here to deliver the message. It is nothing about conversion. We deliver the message, you like it, you accept it, we can't force anyone.
No, I'm not saying
you
about,
tell me one
I'm
thing,
not saying about
irrespective,
you and me.
Irrespective of the non-Muslims, you know, majority non-Muslims didn't accept Islam, correct?
Yeah.
But did they benefit or not?
They certainly will.
They benefit, that's sufficient. Some people get 10 points, some people 20, some people 100.
I agree. Maybe
7-8 people got 100 points benefit. Other people got 10 points. I am satisfied even if you get 1 point benefit.
Whether
did you benefit or not from this lecture?
I did. I certainly
finished. You benefited, I'm happy.
Oh, I'm happy.
I am not asking you to accept Islam.
No.
If you benefited, I am happy.
I benefited. I thank you a lot. I mean, that was, and especially this open forum question answer session was very enlightening. It basically
and very few people allow such open question answer.
Exactly.
Have you seen any Christian? Brother, no. You're a Christian, correct?
I'm not a Christian.
So what are you?
I'm a Brahmin.
Brahmin. Have you seen any Hindu in India having such live open sessions?
No. I mean, I watched your debate with Ravi Shankar and I saw how it happened.
I know. And what happened to him?
And what happened to him? And I also know Pope Benedict refused to talk with you on that Quran issue. Now, thank you. Now, what I mean to say is that we are not saying that people should convert to our religion or your. We're not saying that. We are open people. We are people on a much higher intellectual level. What I'm saying is that how is the world going to be for generations to come? What should we pray? It's not what should we do. See, what we do is in our...
What we should pray? We should pray to Almighty God. What we should do? We should follow His commandments. We should try to find out the truth. And whichever level, you may find 10%, somebody 20%, we have to give the message.
So our duty is to continue giving the message without thinking what the result is going to be.
Not without thinking.
Without.
We are giving the message. And we want the people to follow the true message. Whether they accept or not, I'm not bothered. I cannot force anyone. I cannot compel anyone. Fine?
Yep.
But while giving the message, some people are convinced 10%, some 20%, some 100%. Whatever it is, if I make a difference, I'm happy. Some people may not like it also. That see, Zakir is quoting, they may not like it. So I'm trying my level best to speak the truth and deliver the message. Am I talking about killing anyone here?
No.
Am I talking about torturing anyone?
No.
So if I'm talking about humanity, based on our Creator Almighty God, then what's the problem?
Mr. Jakir, I understand.
Have I told that you should kill the Hindus?
No.
Have I told you should kill the Christians?
I understand your point.
If someone in comparative religion tries to bring animosity,
that is wrong.
Talking about violence,
that is wrong.
Another religion, that is wrong.
But we are not doing it.
Very good.
And let us not talk about people who are doing it. Let us talk about people like you and me, who are not doing all that.
Very good.
Who are only benefiting people by telling them the truth, not forcing them to believe into anything, right? Me and you together.
Very good.
But if that continues, the division remains.
There's no division. What's the division?
The division.
Brother, I love you, brother.
I love you too.
But finish. Christians, so where's the division?
No, I love all of you. The Christians will still keep preaching. The Judaism will still keep preaching.
Let them preach.
But there is division still, isn't it?
Brother, someone, what do you have to realize?
I want to see a world with complete compassion and humanity without no divisions.
So do you think there's no compassion in me?
There's a lot of compassion in you.
Do you think there's no humanity in me?
A lot of it.
So why are you looking at me from the other side?
No, I'm not looking at you. I'm asking you a question. I'm not looking at you. I'm looking at Pope Benedict, who refused to talk to you.
So tell that to Pope Benedict. I am Dr. Zakir Naik, just a student of Islam and comparative religion. I have come here to spread the truth, and I'll continue to spread the truth because that's my message. Because Allah says in the Quran in Surah Fusilah, chapter 41, verse number 33, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَالَ مِمَّنْ دَوَيْلَ اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا قَالَ إِنَّ الْمِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Who is better in speech than one who invites to the way of thy Lord, works righteousness, and says a Muslim? That's the reason I changed from a doctor of body to a doctor of a soul. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.
As you say, Islam is a way of life, as per the Quran, okay? What do you mean by way of life?